Surrey and defending champions Gloucester. So that's an extraordinary fall from grace. Let's get back to Edgbaston because it's time for the presentation ceremony over there. The trophy is now in Birmingham. Matthew Fleming is about to get his hands on it. Let's join Paul Allett.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the presentation of the Norwich Union League Division 1 trophy to the champions, Kent. Matthew Fleming will receive, besides a shower of champagne and beer, a cheque for £54,000 and the trophy. Matthew. Matthew, let's have a word with you. Let's have a word over here. That's a brilliant performance from Kent, really, because you've come up on the rails, haven't you?
Yeah, we haven't made it easy for ourselves. I don't think we've won one game with clear daylight this year, and it's been a real triumph for character and just hanging on in there. And I'd like to pay tribute to Andy Simons today, who, when we looked like faltering, it wasn't worth that. But when we looked like faltering, he grabbed the game by the scruff of the neck and won it for us in the fashion of a really committed overseas professional cricketer. And so all credit to him. And but fantastic for our players as well. We've been bridesmaids so often in the last 15 years, and it's nice to finally grab a groom.
Well, it's the fifth time you've won this trophy, so you're up there at the top. Nobody else has won it more than five times.
Well, yeah, but good point, Paul.
Now, listen, you've had a bit of time to get the celebration sorted, haven't you? You're not going to drive back to Canterbury after this, are you?
Well, I'd like to go back, being a pipe and slippers man, but I fear that... I fear I'm going to be dragged out by some very dangerous people. So
have you booked a hotel room? Are you all sleeping in the back of the car?
Your checkbook, Jazz.
I've been drinking a lot of water, so I'm preparing myself for a quiet night, a quiet celebration in Birmingham.
Well, Matthew, brilliant effort today. Congratulations to you and the lads. You've thoroughly deserved it. Well done.
Can I pay tribute to the amazing Kent fans who've travelled all the way to Edgbaston. It hasn't been the happiest of hunting grounds for us in the last 10 years, but I hope this makes it all worthwhile. Thank you.
Great effort, well done, thanks.
Well, there we are. Matthew Fleming has got his hands on the trophy. And James, just before you go, it does strike me that both captains from Kent and from Leicestershire have spoken really well today. I'm impressed with the way Matthew Fleming's accepted that trophy there, and that's a nice, humble speech. And as far as Vince Wells was concerned, I thought he was very honest.
I'd like to echo the sentiments of Vince Wells and Neil Burns, who spoke well there at the end, congratulating Kent, who played magnificently, but full credit to Vince.
Absolutely. Well, there we are. That is just about it. The scenes and the celebrations which are coming to you from Edgbaston, signs of the early stages of a very heavy evening, I think, for Matthew Fleming and his Kent boys in Birmingham tonight, and they richly deserve it. Pleasant sunshine down in Birmingham now. Here in Nottingham, it's still absolutely pouring with rain. So there we are, we're just about done. My thanks to James Whittaker for being with me today, and of course throughout the season whenever we've come up against Leicestershire. A quick reminder that of course the sport doesn't end just because the domestic cricket season has finished. We've told you about...
Every time I lose you, I'm lost.
Sports and the Norwich Union League working together to deliver great cricket.
Kent Spitfires have won the National League title. They pipped Leicestershire on the very last day of the season after the Foxes had led for most of the campaign.
Champagne was flowing at Edgbaston as Kent celebrated their first trophy of any kind since 1995. And that's come as something of a relief.
We've been bridesmaids so often in the last 15 years, and it's nice to finally grab a groom.
Leicestershire had led the National League for much of the season. They still had their mascot in attendance, but their star player Shahid Afridi was thousands of miles away in Pakistan. Jonathan Dakin and Trevor Ward laboured in the early overs. Dakin eventually out in the 12th after a less than electrifying start. Leicester continued to lose early wickets and were 51 for 4 before Darren Stevens and Neil Burns put on a sensible 59 to turn things around. Stevens went to a magnificent catch by John Morris. And when Burns had made 43, he gave a more straightforward one to the same fielder. Leicester lost momentum again and lost wickets and closed on 185 for 9. Meanwhile at Edgbaston, Kent found batting no easier. David Fulton, a big run scorer in the Championship, called at the wicket for just 6. And when the dangerous Aussie Andrew Symonds followed Matthew Fleming back to the pavilion, Kent badly needed someone to stick around. That someone was James Hockley, who guided the Spitfires with 90, including 12 fours and a 6. And he was joined by Robert Key, who went for quick runs to lift Kent to 216 after their allotted overs. Though the rains meant the Duckworth-Lewis system would come into force with an amended target for Warwickshire. And when the home side batted, Mark Waugh and Ian Bell put on 89 for the second wicket to put pressure on the Kent bowling. Back at Trent Bridge, Nottinghamshire's John Morris set the tone for the Outlaws innings, going after Dakin early on. He'd eventually finish with a half century in his farewell match in the top flight. Greg Blewett and Darren Bignall's second wicket stand was the decisive one to take the Outlaws nearer to a victory that would also enable them to avoid relegation. The winning runs soon came for Nottinghamshire, and Leicestershire could only wait for the result to come in from Birmingham. An anxious time for their skipper, Vince Wells. And the news was not good. Warwickshire were running out of overs and running out of wickets. David Hemp brilliantly run out for 21 near the end. Soon Matthew Fleming was tasting victory, but he promises the celebrations will be suitably understated.
You're not going to drive back to Canterbury after this, are you?
Well, I'd like to go back, being a pipe and slippers man, but I fear that... I fear I'm going to be dragged out by some... by some very dangerous people.
It's Kent's fifth national title, and that's a record. Philip Barker, Sky Sports.
I think they're going to enjoy that.
They should take care, shouldn't they?
OK, see you with us here on